All right, now this is getting serious. Former executives over at Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae are now facing some fraud charges. The Securities and Exchange Commission just filing those charges against former Fannie CEO Daniel Mudd, former Freddie CEO Richard Syron. They're accused, along with four other execs, of misleading investors about some risky subprime loans, the underpinning of the housing crisis. Kate Obenshain says it shouldn't end there. She's with the Young Americas Foundation. Kate, this could escalate into something big here, right?
Well, it certainly should. If you look at the fact that Freddie Mae and Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae have knowingly been propped up by $160 billion in taxpayer funds, that their executives have knowingly misled the public at a time of intense scrutiny, intense concern. Look, these organizations have all the security of a government organization. By the way, this is what happens when the government steps in and tries to do something better than the private sector. But they have all the security of a government organization, and yet they have the pay scale of the private sector, paid millions of dollars when you include all their bonuses. So yes, there should be a lot of scrutiny, and it shouldn't just be these six sacrificial lambs.
You know what interests me a lot about this case, regardless of where these charges go, you always assume innocent until proven guilty, of course, but that Freddie Mac, Fannie Mae left out of the big financial reform law, and I'm just wondering, post Frank Dodd, this big reform, when you leave the two biggest players in the housing morass out of what should be a legal fix, we're in a bigger fix.
Yes, exactly. And it's all politically motivated. And it's fascinating as well that political players have been left out of the investigation. Franklin Raines, the president's buddy who served on his transition team, you don't see his name anywhere. There are a lot of congressional players.
Well, maybe you will.
You will. But the congressional players in this also have to be investigated, because they, in essence, were the ones that pushed through, it really bullied and forced banks to make these very questionable loans, economically questionable but politically palatable. And so they have to bear a significant amount of responsibility in all of this.
Laura, we should explain to people who aren't nearly as up on this as you are and always are, that the loans in question were to broaden the base of lending so that housing moved and mortgage lending moved from a goal to what amounted to a right for everybody. And then lending was expanded to people who were even risky on paper, zero doc loans and all these backed by Fannie and Freddie. Now, if the executives at these institutions knew, in fact, that what they were doling out and what they were doing with banks was stupid and wrong and even just deceitful, is that criminal?
Well, I think it absolutely is when these executives go on their conference calls and say, look, we haven't really been involved in the subprime mortgage area, and it's only a tiny percentage of our portfolio, when we actually find out that it's billions and billions, hundreds of billions of their portfolio. That is knowingly misleading the public as to their risk. And these are extremely risky loans. It's not only the economic consequences. Neil, you talk about giving loans to people who otherwise would not qualify for them. What a noble, wonderfully American goal. But the problem is you force people into loans that they could never, ever pay back. And so then they end up in foreclosure. By the way, it's exactly what the government is doing in our student loan industry. As the government takes over that, they are granting these loans that students will never, ever be able to pay back. And there will be significant consequences, not just for these people, just like the homeowners who were foreclosed upon, but the students who won't be able to pay back these enormous loans.
Well, like you say, I don't think it's over by any means. Kate,
it's
thank you.
Over.
Very good seeing you. Have a good weekend.
Thank you. You too. Merry Christmas.
To you as well.